previous video, you learned what are DHCP options and how to configure options. In this video, you will learn how to create DHCP split scope. Let's start. DHCP server is one of the most crucial services in any network. If your DHCP server fails, clients would not be able to receive new IP addresses or renew their existing IP. Therefore, making sure DHCP service can continue to work in case of a server failure becomes a high priority in any network with DHCP. There are several DHCP high availability solutions offered by Microsoft. Solutions like DHCP Split Scope, DHCP Failover, and DHCP Server Cluster. DHCP Server Cluster requires complex network and software setup. I will create detailed videos about Microsoft Server Clusters and what services can be run on clusters. In this video, I will cover DHCP Split Scope, and in the next video, I will cover DHCP Failover. Let's start with DHCP Split Scope. With DHCP Split Scope, as the name suggests, you will split one scope into multiple servers. You will create two DHCP servers and split a scope between them. Both DHCP servers can serve IP addresses to the clients from the same IP address pool. But you usually configure one server as primary, and the second server, or so-called the additional DHCP server, will lease IP addresses only when the primary server is down. You can break your scope into any sizes that you would like. Maybe assign 80% of the IP range to the first DHCP server and keep the next 20% for the second server. With this approach, if server 1 fails, server 2 has a scope with 20% capacity of the entire pool that can answer and serve users until you bring the primary server online. You can achieve this manually by creating the scope on both servers and adding exclusion range. The range that is being served on server 1 should be excluded from server 2, and the range served on server 2 should be excluded from server 1. Manual process is not fun, but it is doable. DHCP server role has a wizard that allows you to create a split scope as easy as possible. Let's start creating our split scope. Log into your first server and open DHCP console. Review the scope or scopes that you would like to split. Review the address pool range, exclusion range, address lease, reservation and options. Then log into your second server and open DHCP console. If you need to know how to install DHCP server, click the link on top of your screen to watch that video. Check the DHCP console before starting the process and review any existing scopes. Now that you have prepared the destination server, log back in your first DHCP server or so-called the primary server, right-click on the scope that you want to split, and from the advanced menu, select Split Scope. On the open wizard, click Next to start. In this page, you have to add your second or additional DHCP server. Click Add Server and Browse. On the open dialog box, enter your second server name, hit Check Name, and then click OK. Your server name will be added to this server field. Click OK to close this page and go back to the wizard. On the wizard, click Next to continue. Next page of the wizard is where you can select your desired split percentage. You can either drag the handlebar to the left or right, or type in the desired percentage in the designated fields. Once you change the percentage, you can see that the start and end IP address for each of the servers will change. You can also notice that the host or primary server will host a section of the addresses, and the additional DHCP server or the secondary server will host the rest of the available IP in that range. On the next page, you can set DHCP delays for each of the servers separately. This is a value in milliseconds. When you set a delay time, the DHCP server will wait for the specified amount of time before responding to clients. This can avoid IP conflicts. On the next page, you can see a summary of settings you have decided. Click Finish. System will complete the setup and shows you the summary. Click Close to exit the wizard. To check the completion of the process, log in to your secondary DHCP server and refresh the console. Now you can see the scopes on this server as well. Activate the scope and check the address pool range. As you can notice, the range is the same as primary server, with one difference, the exclusion range. The exclusion ranges are different between primary and additional server. The IP range that is available on primary server is excluded on additional server, and the range that is available on the additional server is excluded from the primary server. Now that you have created your split scope, there are a few important notes that I would like to mention. First note is about the reservations. If you are using reservations, you need to create them manually on both servers. This is to allow both servers to offer reserved IP addresses the same way. The The DHCP split scope function does not replicate reservations. You need to create them manually. Second note, if one DHCP server fails, the lease information stored on that server is lost with it as well. The lease information is not replicated. And third, because the second server has only a portion of the IP addresses available to lease, it could run out of IP addresses before you bring the failed server back online. These issues can be resolved by using DHCP failover. I hope you enjoyed this video. Join me on the next video to learn how to create DHCP failover. See you on the next video.